Hi, I'm Mary from Blackmagic Design.
And I'm Ray Barr from LumaForge.
And we're here to talk about collaboration in DaVinci Resolve Studio 14. We're going to be using today the Jellyfish.
We are.
Tell me about it.
The Jellyfish Mobile. So the cool thing about the Jellyfish Mobile is, for DaVinci especially, you can have your Postgres SQL on the actual server, mm-hmm. as well as all the media that you're using for the edit.
And there's just two of us, but if we were doing post-production, we could have a whole crew or an entire department working all using the same Jellyfish. So that's kind of exciting. So to set that up, you have a choice. You can be on your local database, which is basically working on one disk or on one system. And I'm going to go down here to the server, and that way I'm connected to the Jellyfish. And what I'll do is I'll take a project. I'm going to go to this one called Vacancy Working. This is a short film. I'm going to go ahead and open it up. Now at the moment, it's just a project on the server. And what I'll do is I will enable it for collaboration, and then you will be able to join me.
Perfect.
So to enable the project for collaboration, I just go up to the File menu, and I'll go down to Enable Collaboration. Enable Collaboration, and what it'll do is it'll save the project. That's the first thing that happens. And it always does a save, but here's the cool part. Once it's saved the project and it becomes collaborative, I never have to save again. Live save is automatically turned on, so everything I do or any of the collaborators do is automatically saved every click, which is very cool. And so now my project is set for collaboration. So if you want to go ahead and join.
I'm seeing Vacancy Working, and I see an icon with two little guys.
Right, that's the icon that shows it is now a collaborative process. So go ahead and join me. Now, one of the things that happened when I enabled this project for collaboration is it automatically set me in the master position, or at the top level of the bin list over here on the top left. Notice it's sitting there. So what you're seeing is a little white icon. That's me. That's my badge. Now, right now it's white, which is the default. So the first thing we should do in collaboration is go ahead and set up our identities. So down in the bottom right of your screen, you'll see an icon that looks like the same one you saw in the project. Go ahead and click on that. And both of ours will be different. It'll show you and tell whatever computer you're on. And you can go ahead and put your name in it if you want. You could use your first name, or I'll do editor and you do assistant. And also it's a good idea to pick a unique color. So I think I'll be yellow for this demo.
And I will be teal.
Oh, how nice. There you go. So now I can see who I'm working with. And again, in this case, there's just the two of us, but I've worked where there's many users, and it's nice you can go down through and see them right away. So
wonderful.
Now that I jump out, now I can't see you, but look over on your screen and you can see me right there in the master position. So let's go down to our timelines. I'm gonna show you something. If I select the timelines, notice I got there first. And if you look at your screen, you're gonna see that yellow badge. That means I'm there and I have locked that bin, so to speak. So I'm gonna now step into the bin, and I'm gonna choose the locked picture bin. And once I do that, you can now select a different bin.
I'll do working timelines.
Okay, so if you do the working timelines, now I just backed myself up to timelines, and now I can look in and see which bin you actually are on, and I can see that right away. So it works both ways. And if I hover over your icon, I can see who it is, in case I didn't know ahead of time. So anytime I hover over that. Now the way the bin locking works is by selecting this bin, I now have a lock on the bin and all the contents. In this case, it's only one timeline. But I'm going to open that timeline, and there you can see the project. So I not only own the bin, but also I control the contents. You can also open the same timeline, but take a look. Mine has a red playhead, which means it's active, and I can make edits, I can make any changes I need to in either the edit page or the Fairlight page because I control the timeline. Notice your playhead is gray, which means you're in read-only mode. And that's really useful because that means we can both be on the same timeline, just only one of us will be making changes that will impact the duration of the project.
Yeah.
Let's talk about a couple things that we can do together. Now, I just mentioned that only one person can make physical edits to the timeline, but you can have more than one colorist. So let's go in to the color page. And there I can see your icon right there on the clip that you're on. So let me select one right next to yours. And you see how you see me, I see you.
I see you, you see me.
And so I can go in and ask you to change the grade. Maybe you can grade one character, I grade another, or we're working on exterior and interior parts of the same scene, whatever it is, we can both be working at the same time. Once I've done anything to that shot, applied any change at all, you notice there's a little rainbow now. If I step out of this clip, which I'm doing right now, you should get a refresh icon. And what the refresh shows you is that I've made a change, and you click that right away, and whatever I did, you can now see it. So we'll live update all the time. And what I'd like to do is, I actually have a job for you. I'm going to invite you by using the chat feature. So let's go down to the collaboration chat.
Okay.
That's in the bottom right corner. It looks like a little chat icon. Okay, so I'm going to just ask you if you can add some titles to the end of the locked sequence. I'll hit return, and you notice there's my note.
The chat icon shows me that I have a new message,
that's
so I'm
correct.
Going to click it.
There you go.
Hey, look at that.
I'm going to have you go into working timelines, find the titles,
okay.
Add a transition to them because there's just cuts right now, and then bring the title sequence into the locked picture. I saw a chat. Let's take a look at it. Oh, good. You finished. Excellent. Now, what's cool is not only did you finished it on the timeline I'm actually in. And right there at the end, I can see there's the end titles that you added. And you want to see something really cool? Instead of seeing this as a sequence, I'm going to decompose it in place. There we go. There's my title sequence.
There's so many timelines in action right now. So mm-hmm. Is there a simple way to compare two different timelines to one another?
Absolutely, and especially on a big project where you have a lot of different reels or different people working on it, some doing the rough cuts and then refining and refining, it's always nice to be able to look at the different processes the timeline goes through and compare it. And you can do that right here. In DaVinci Resolve, there's a timeline comparison tool. Right now I have version 2 open, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up version 1 instead, which does not have the titles, and there's a slight difference between those, one different way that we did the ending, and I want to go compare the two. To compare the timelines, all you have to do is select a different timeline that you want to compare and right-click and choose Compare with Current Timeline. It doesn't have to be in the same bin, it just has to be somewhere in the project.
Okay.
So as you can see, there's a different playhead on each of my comparative timelines. The timeline on top is the one I'm comparing, and the one on the bottom is mine. And if you look over here, there's an index that shows all the differences between the two timelines. It shows every single edit, and it allows me to select an edit, and I can go in and figure out what's going on where. So very useful to have the index. And then here, the reason I have the red and the green is it's showing me that the same exact shot is in two different locations. So if I'm going to accept one, there may be a conflict, so I have to be aware of that. So shot 17 up here is also in the same place here. So I'm going to look at the ending on this top timeline. Okay, that's with the fade, and then I'm going to look at it down here and decide which of the two I'm going to keep. And if I want to accept the changes, I can just right-click and choose Accept Change. And when it does that, it will take that element and drop it right down into this timeline. Now, of course, this part is now different, so I can also accept another change as well. And that way, now I have fixed anything that was maybe thrown the continuity in the scene. And I also have the titles on my top timeline, and I'd like to add those down here so I can also accept that change as well. So that's the collaboration process. Now, do you think you can start using it on your own project?
Definitely. I think this is fantastic. I mean, now I can get my assistants on there, editors, sound designers, colorists, everybody on the same platform, and the possibilities are quite endless.
That's right. It's now conformless post-production, where you don't have to transfer your media, you don't have to wait around for each different element to finish before you can get started. Imagine eliminating the waiting and actually get started right away, and gives a little more time for creativity, too.
It's just black magic right there. Thank you guys for watching. We really appreciate you. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments below. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.